What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, my name is Beth, and in today's video, I'm going to be giving you guys a little bit of a 33-week, hello to Max, 33-week pregnancy update because I realized that I am now well into the third trimester, and it's been a long time since I've given you guys a bump date or just an update on how I'm feeling. I didn't recap anything from second trimester, and I didn't want the third to go by without recapping anything either, so I'm gonna do that today. But to be honest, this was not the video that I had planned for this week. I had actually planned for another one that I'll post in a future week, but I just didn't feel good sitting down and making that video this week because I have honestly just felt like a little bit mentally and emotionally and physically just off. And so it didn't feel super genuine to sit down and be all peppy and film that exciting video. So I'm gonna do that in a future week, but I was honestly just gonna skip posting this week altogether. I was like, people do not need to see me in this space. Like, it's not helpful. But then I realized no, it actually probably is helpful to just film a real update and share with you guys how I'm actually doing and where things are really at. So that's what I'm going to be doing today. I'm going to grab a cup of coffee and then we can sit down and just chat. So I'm gonna do that now and we will get chatting. All right, we've got our coffee cozy in my bedroom right now, ready to chat with you guys. Before I get into kind of the update of how I'm doing, I'll give you the general update of where I'm at right now in third trimester. So according to my pregnancy app, I am 33 weeks and one day. So apparently that means that the baby is big as a butternut squash. I don't know what that means. I feel like the size comparisons are changing and never make sense. Like, the other comparison that it gives is the box of chocolates from Forrest Gump. So whatever that means, I don't know. But apparently she's about 17 inches right now and weighs around 4.25 pounds, which is bigger than our dog, so that's a little bit insane. And we technically only have about 7 weeks to go. So in terms of what it's saying I can expect right now, it's things like strong fetal movement, which is very much what I'm experiencing, shortness of breath, which is another thing I'm experiencing, so you may hear some of that in this video, but then just general contractions and stuff like that that I will get into as I talk to you guys. But I figured I would also just give you a little bump date as well. I haven't been filming the pregnancy transition every single week or anything like that in terms of belly progression. I thought about doing that and I was like, that seems like so much work and I'm already so tired as it is, so I won't be doing that this pregnancy. But I did want to film a little just bump date so I can look back on this from third trimester and remember what it looked like. I'm gonna try and find a way to do this that isn't super weird. So this is what she's looking like right now. I mean, you can kind of see the size of the bump. I guess when I have the leggings down, it's a little bit easier to see, but I'm still carrying very much all over the front, I feel like. She has dropped a little bit from second trimester, but not so much that it looks like she's gonna come out yet. You can still very much see that there's quite a bit of baby up here, and I can definitely feel that. When she's stretched out, I feel her here, I feel her down here, I feel her on the sides. So there is a lot of baby in there and not a lot of room is what it feels like at this point. In terms of stretch marks and stuff like that, I have been getting those more towards the birth, on my sides. I have been getting them quite a bit. Closer to the beginning of the pregnancy, I got them here, I got them on my inner thighs, but I'm starting to get a few just really tiny ones underneath my belly as well. So I'm not sure if that will kind of expand upwards by the time that I'm done, but we'll see. I mean, it's whatever at this point. I'm not super concerned about it, but it was one of those things that I was like, oh, I don't know if I'll get any on my belly with the rate that this is going. And then sure enough, in third trimester, they did pop up. So those are there as well. Before I keep going, I just need to take a breath. Okay. As I was saying, in terms of how I'm feeling right now, I feel like physically it has been very challenging, especially in this last week, just because it does feel like she's so big in there and she's so stretched out. And to be honest, thinking about the fact that there is still another 7 weeks to go of her getting bigger and don't get me wrong, like that's exactly what we want. We want her to stay in, we want her to keep getting bigger and to get healthier and just be ready to enter the world whenever like God intends for her to do that. But like the day in and day out has definitely been getting more challenging, and like I'm still working full time right now. I'm still doing YouTube, I'm still working with brands and trying to do all of the things that I've committed to. And so like balancing, I think, just like the physical toll that it takes with like life not slowing down at all has been super, super hard in the past couple weeks. And this week I think is when it hit me the most, where it was just like, oh my gosh, like I am so tired. And it's hard because you want to give yourself that grace and the space to be like, I can rest right now. Like I can sit, I don't need to be running and getting all this stuff done all the time. But then at the same time, like not wanting to let anyone else down, not wanting to let yourself down. And so I feel like it's just been this back and forth struggle for me this week of just like feeling so stretched out and just feeling like honestly tired of all of the body changes that have been happening. And it's so fun to be able to carry her with me, but I also do feel like I've gotten to the point now where it's like, I would love to carry you outside of me, if that makes sense. I would just love to be able to both of us have our own space and to meet you and to be towards the finish line of this pregnancy. So that's kind of where I've been at with it, just like physically. My hips are, I think, done stretching to what I can tell in terms of what I feel in the like weeks leading up to 33 weeks. So probably like 32 maybe, I was feeling a lot of that like hip stretching feeling. And it's hard to explain what that feels like other than almost like growing pains, but in the sides of your hips. I found that walking and movement and stuff was really helpful for that. But then like obviously when I went to bed at night, like laying on those hips, I was having really bad sleeps because I would have to lay on one side, and then in the middle of the night when that hip got really sore, it would actually wake me up to the point where I had to like get up and then flip over to the other side. I don't have that anymore, which I'm just super grateful for. I don't know if it'll come back or not. But it's mostly just been now like the general achiness of like my back is really sore, my ankles have been sore, and then sleeping, I would say I'm still sleeping right now. I'm getting probably like five or six hours a night, but I am getting up quite a bit more because I can feel that she's a little bit lower. So if I drink like any water before bed, I will be up in the night on average probably 2 to 3 times. The other night I was up 5 times, and that was just like insane. It was like I might as well just sleep in the bathroom because I feel like every time I shift slightly, like I have to pee again. But on the whole, sleep has been pretty good, so I'm just like enjoying that right now. And then also just like trying to reconcile the fact that like honestly, if I'm used to waking up in the night right now, it's not a huge deal because by the time that she comes, I will be ready to party all night with her. So that has been okay. One of the other things that's been a little bit strange in the past couple of weeks is the fact that I have not seen an OB since I was 29 weeks. So I'm 33 weeks now, which means that it's been a while since I've gotten an update on how I'm looking, on how baby's measuring, and all of these different things. And I didn't share this in previous pregnancy videos, but basically I have something called circumvallate placenta, and my doctor's not concerned about it at all, the OB's not concerned about it at all, but when you Google that, it's a little bit terrifying to read some of the things that people are saying online about it. And I am just going with what my OB says. Like, she's delivered tons and tons of babies and moms with this condition, and so I'm not super concerned about it. But one of the elements of that is that it can actually slow down baby's growth, and so you want to be tracking with that really closely over time. And not having had an appointment in so long because of the pandemic has been another thing that I've just been trying to balance mentally. I didn't think that I would cry, but okay, we're good. Yeah, I think it's just the fact that it's that, but it's coupled with so many other things that are going on right now, if that makes sense. Like, It's the fact that we have spent so much time in lockdown in Ontario over the past year. Like, almost all of my pregnancy has been in lockdown, and even when I posted like the announcement of telling friends and family, like, I had to wait so long to tell some people in person because we just like legally have not been able to see people to the extent that we're used to. And then little things of like baby showers are all going to be online because the stay-at-home order that we're in right now with the pandemic in Ontario doesn't end until May 20th. So every single one of the baby showers that was planned with family and friends ended up falling into the timeline for things to be canceled in person. So all of that is online, and it's totally fine for things to be online, but you also do want to experience being able to see friends and family in person. With a season like this, church is back online right now, so it's not like seeing people in person. And then I think one of the other big things that I had to do this past week was actually cancel Jared and I's baby moon, which was a bummer to say the least, because we were really looking forward to having that time away, just the two of us before she came. So it's not that it's any one of those things on its own, it's just like the combination of all of that stuff and just like bearing the weight of that while spending so much time alone, even just at home, because I am working from home right now. And it's a lot mentally to handle and to balance when you are also just going through something that is such a huge life change, like getting ready to welcome a baby into the world. And so that's just like honestly where I'm at right now. As you can see, like, it is not always easy. And I wanted to make a video just coming from that place of being like, this is hard and it's okay for it to be hard. And I am trying really hard right now to balance the perspective of like, God is still on the throne. All of this stuff is short-lived. Like, our baby is healthy. I firmly believe that at the end of the day. I believe that my labor and delivery is going to go well, that she's going to be totally healthy when she comes out. I am so grateful for the friends and family that we do have around us, even if it is mostly online right now. Like, we can still do church online. We can still, like, we have access to God whenever and wherever. And so it's been an interesting thing for me to walk through, just like such a strange season in terms of like being so excited about her coming, but also balancing like these crazy things that are going on in our world right now. Like, this is such a strange thing. It honestly feels like a movie that we just like keep pressing play on, or like a dream that you just can't wake up from. But there's still so much good in it at the end of the day. And I think, like, even for anyone watching this, if you are in that position as well, where you're just feeling like I have to be strong, like the only thing that we can do is just hold on to hope, whatever, like, all of that stuff is like true to some degree. Like, we do need to hold on to hope because this isn't going to last forever. However, there is something to be said about holding space for yourself in terms of like just feeling the things that you're feeling and allowing yourself to be like, parts of this really suck. And that's just how it is. Like, you're allowed to be able to feel those things at the end of the day. It is so important to talk about them and to let people into it. But even just like letting Jared in on more things in terms of how I'm feeling and talking through it with him has been so, so helpful. But then also taking those things to God has been helpful too, because in this past week, I was just like, I was at this point where I was just so frustrated, and I realized it had been such a long time since I prayed about any of those things. And even though it can seem silly to be like, oh, I'm so upset that like my baby shower, for example, isn't in person, I am the type of person that's like, okay, like, let's just move on, whatever. But I feel like there is something to be said about bringing even those things that do feel small compared to other people's experiences and what they're going through. Like, God, there's nothing that he looks at in your life and thinks like, that's too small. Like, you shouldn't be bringing something like that to me. Like, he actually wants us to bring all of that to him. And so I am working at that through this process of like every single day when I'm experiencing something that is just like keeping me down or holding me back from being able to just rest in his peace and the knowledge that things are gonna be okay. I'm just working on that process of bringing everything to him, like, no matter how big or how small, because he really does care about all of that stuff too. A verse that's been really helpful for me, even just in the past couple of days, is Isaiah 40 verse 31. And it says, "Those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not be faint. And that has just been like just speaking to my soul right now, because I have felt so much like I've just come to the end of myself in so many different ways, like with this pandemic especially, like emotionally and spiritually and in so many different seasons of it, but now physically as well. That was one of those things. It's like, well, if I don't have emotional and spiritual, I can ride out on the physical. But now it's like, okay, I'm physically exhausted as well. I am literally to the end of myself. But we know that his power is made perfect in our weakness. And so relying on him, waiting on him, I know that that is what is ultimately going to renew my strength at the end of the day. And so if you guys are going through tough times right now too, even just drop a comment in the chat. I want to be able to pray for you guys, because this has been a hard season. And even if you're in a location right now where maybe the pandemic is not what it is currently in Canada, it's still tough. And there are obviously ramifications of all the things that we've gone through that still fade into this season. And so I want to be able to pray for you guys. So let me know down below if you do need that. Outside of all of that stuff, I feel like things in pregnancy generally are going really well right now. I still feel really healthy. I feel like we are getting close to being ready for her arrival, and the nursery is coming along, and there are just like so many things that I'm looking forward to sharing with you guys in future weeks. Like, I will be doing a nursery reveal. I will be sharing with you guys baby shower updates, things about like what we got and the registry and all of that fun stuff. An exciting video that is going to be coming up soon is one all about names that we like and some baby girl name hints as well. And so I would love for you guys to just stay updated on everything that's coming with this pregnancy by subscribing to this channel, because we are getting close and there will be so many videos over the next couple of weeks as we prepare for her arrival. I feel like I am going to focus on that more so in terms of content and stuff for the next couple weeks. So subscribe if you don't want to miss that. And also just like this video if it helped you today. I want to know what types of things you guys like. And so every time you like a video, it just gives me an indication of the types of things that you want to see on my channel. So that would be super helpful. But another thing that I wanted to let you guys know is that when this baby girl is born, the people that follow me on Instagram are going to be the first to know. Just practically, it's going to be so much easier for me to be able to post there to announce her birth versus like have the whole birth vlog and all of that stuff uploaded here. So make sure that you follow me on Instagram at Beth Grace Moore so you don't miss out on that exciting announcement when it could come. I mean, not any day now, because if we do still have some time to go, but we are getting super, super close. And I don't know what the like measuring signs are for experiencing labor, because I've never done it before, obviously. But I do feel like she could come very soon, because I have had lots of Braxton Hicks and all of those fun things. So make sure that you are following on Instagram so you don't miss that announcement. And I guess until next week's video, I love you guys. I'm praying for you guys. I hope that you are doing well, and I will see you soon.